Today I'm going to be taking you through a brief 20-minute recovery flow, which would be great for anybody who's trying to relieve stress. Not only just athletes, but anybody who's just trying to maybe take some of their tension out of their body and just feel better. So what we're going to need today are going to be a foam roller, and if you have a lacrosse ball, that's great. If you don't, it's not required. We can do without. I'm also going to use a yoga mat, but we don't need that either. So first, we're going to start with breathing. So what I'm gonna ask us to do is let's take our foam roller, and if we can go by the wall, that would be great. If you don't, we can just keep our feet flat on the floor, just like so, the foam roller in between our knees. Starting with our feet on the wall, we wanna get about a 90 degree angle at the knees and the hips. So here I'm gonna give us a cadence to focus on as we breathe. We're gonna go 4 seconds in and 4 seconds out. You're gonna notice how I first fill up my belly. And then as the air fills up my belly, I'm gonna slowly bring it up into my chest, breathing in through my nose and exhaling out of my mouth. Let's begin. Keeping the shoulders relaxed. Try to loosen as much tension through your body as we take a nice deep breath in for 4. And exhale for 4. Paying attention to how our shoulders are. They should be nice and loose, relaxed. We shouldn't feel any tension in our neck. All we're feeling is the air go in and out. Let's take one more. This time, especially focusing on where air is going into our torso. And next, we're going to be taking our lacrosse ball and working on the bottoms of our feet. So starting at the heel, we're gonna really attack just the areas in front of the heel. We have a lot of tissues that coordinate and go right into our heel. So this is a good area, especially if we wake up in the morning with some sensitive feet, or if we're putting a lot of mileage out on the track or on the course. Moving on to the other side. Good. And from here, you can also do some flexing of the toes and extending once you find a sensitive area. Now, moving on, we're going to use our lacrosse ball to work on our calves. So what I like to do is I like to drop into a 90-90 position. Doesn't necessarily have to be here, but we're going to bisect our shin and just focus on the lower half. So using our thumb, we can also use our thumb here if we don't have a ball, but we're gonna find the border of our shin and our calves. So once we've located it, you'll probably notice it's a sensitive area, especially if you press hard. We're gonna use our lacrosse ball and just tack down some areas while moving our toes up and down. You can do this for as long as you feel like you need. We're gonna kind of be moving quick today. So as we do a few of those, loosening up our calves, we can now transition to the other side. Moving on to the other leg, same thing, we bisect the shin and from tacking down that tissue and flexing and extending our ankle. Next, we've hit part of the calf, but now we're gonna go a layer deeper. So how we're gonna do that is we're gonna take our foam roller and we're gonna turn into a little bit of a ledge here. So I have enough space that I can freely move my foot up and down. And now you can, again, use your finger, but this time we're gonna be using the lacrosse ball. So as I let that ball sink into the tissue, we're gonna flex and extend at the ankle. And especially this area should feel very sensitive. We're getting some of the deepest tissues in the calf, and the pressure should be light, but as you get comfortable, you can add a little bit more. Great, moving on to the other side. Again, make that ledge, tack it down, flex, extend. So we can go anywhere between 5, 20 flex extend, and then continue to move down as needed. Moving on, we're gonna do our hips next. So I often like to ask athletes to just find that bony part of our hip. If you're not sure, we make a nice broad handprint on the outside of our hip, and we just wiggle the thigh back and forth. So here I can feel that bump moving back and forth under my hand. So now we can take our lacrosse ball and try to find the tissues behind that bump. Moving up and down, once we feel a sensitive area, we can open and close. As I drop it down, you might feel like that tissue really, really takes on that ball and you can feel a lot of tension. So again, do as much as you feel needed. We're gonna quickly move on to the other side. So here, I've located that area, and we're gonna flex extend. Also in this position, we can do some kicks, clamshells, or just dull pressure. Next, we're gonna move it on to the foam roller. So for the foam roller, we're gonna actually start with our lower back. So what I ask is we sit onto the roller and slowly ride down until we're just at the top of the hips or the bottom of the low back. So once we're here, we can get a little bit familiar with that roller. And then once we feel like we know what we're trying to get after here, we're gonna switch to one side. So I turn my knees, turn my hips to one area, and that's really gonna help me hit my right side of my low back. Moving on, we're gonna go to the left side, same thing, comparing to see which side maybe feels a little more sensitive, and we can spend more time on that side. Moving on, let's go to our thighs. So here, we're gonna take our foam roller, and let's start with the inner thighs. So I'm especially gonna focus on the inner thigh really, really close to the hip. So how we're gonna do that is we're gonna turn our foam roller north and south and put our knee up to the level of the hip. Relaxing that leg, so most of my pressure is on my left hand, left elbow, and left thigh as I roll my right hip. Next, we're gonna move on to the other side. So from here again, foam roller goes north and south, and we want to hit that area high up close to the hip. After we finish with our inner thighs, we can go on to our quads. So when we're doing our quads, let's do our right leg first. I'm going to try to hit the area all the way from my knee to my hip, maybe prioritizing spots just below the hip or just above the knee here. So first we're going to tension seek, going up and down until we find an area, let's say we find right above the knee. We're gonna hold this position and let's just wag the tail. Now in this position, it's really easy for us to kind of forget about our body mechanics. So we wanna like drop our hips because this feels comfortable, but we're putting a lot of pressure on our low back. So let's just try to keep our hips supported by lifting our rib cage up towards the ceiling. So once we wag the tail a few times, we can flex extend and then move up towards the upper thigh, same thing, wag the tail, and flex extend. Now, before we move on to our other side, what we're gonna do is we're gonna actually hit the outside of the thigh. So how we're gonna do that is the same way we just did. We're gonna go from our knee to our hip, and then once you feel like you've found some tension, especially closer towards the knee, same techniques. We're gonna do wag the tail first, and then flex extend. So, like anything with the foam roller, spend more time on sensitive areas, and look for areas of tension. Moving on to the other side, we're gonna do the same thing. Let's tension seek, hip to knee. Once we do that a few times, we can move it on to above the knee. Let's wag the tail and flex extend. Good. Moving on up to the hip, wag the tail, flex extend. Moving on to the outer side, tension seek, find some nice areas. Let's wag the tail. So up until this point, it's about 10 minutes in, and we could probably spend another 10 minutes here. But moving on, what we're going to do next is we're going to go into our quad hip stretch against the wall. So how we're going to get into that stretch, we're going to start nice and close to the wall, putting our foot about 6 to 8 inches up. We're going to put our left foot right next to the foam roller and then come up nice and tall, just like so. So as long as I'm sitting up nice and tall, I'm squeezing my butt while keeping my rib cage down, I should feel a nice stretch through here. Now this is our position one. We actually might feel more of a stretch, or we might be able to get a little bit more if we go down into this second position down here. But for right now, I'm gonna stay in position one. We're gonna take 3 deep breaths. Long exhale. Deep breath in. And as I exhale here, I'm gonna really make sure that I'm exhaling all that air out so I can feel my six pack kick on. And also I'm gonna squeeze my hip a little bit here so I can get a lot of tension in that front of the hip. One more time. Switching sides, quick switch, so match up the knees. Right foot comes by the right hand, and we sit up nice and tall. So spend more time on areas that feel more tense. You might feel that there's more asymmetry. One side feels a little bit tighter than the other. So spend more time there. We're holding each for no less than 3 breaths. Once we finish with that, we're gonna go into our adductor rock. So from here, we're gonna hold the foam roller in between our knees, spread our knees out as far as we can first, and then let's kick out the left leg. So here I can feel a stretch on my inner thigh, and then paying attention to my ankle, because I can cheat it a little bit. If I have my foot just like so, I won't get as much of a stretch. So we're gonna lock down that ankle right there. And we're gonna rock for 10. And then we're going to turn our foot up towards the ceiling, and we'll rock for another 10. After we've done that side, let's move on to the other side. And what you're gonna notice here is when I switch to my side, just pay attention to this foot here. So, spreading on our knees, kicking out that right leg, you're gonna notice that I have my toes engaged. So this is gonna be nice because it's gonna allow us to work on our toe or our big toe mobility, which sometimes we lose as we're wearing shoes and often becomes problematic for people with ankle or lower body pathologies. Let's turn that toe up towards the ceiling, sitting up and down. Good. All right, next, we're gonna go with two different options for our hips. So the first one we can do is either posterior hip capsule, or we can go into the pigeon stretch. So we've seen pigeon stretch before. When we're in pigeon stretch, what we do is we start in a bear position. We kick back the right leg, swivel the left as much as you can, and then continue to slide back, keeping your hips square with the floor. Now the big mistake that we see here is we usually open up, and that kind of desensitizes the stretch. So sometimes that might be the foot is too far forward, so we just need to pull it back a little bit, or we just need to pay attention to how we're placing our hips down on the ground. So we've seen pigeon stretch before, but instead of that, we're gonna try posterior hip capsule stretch. So a posterior hip capsule stretch, we're gonna kick back the right leg, swivel the left, and instead of sliding back, we're just gonna drop that back knee, and now I'm gonna press my hips up and towards the side of the front knee. Okay, so if we're doing this correctly, you're gonna notice you feel a nice dull stretch in that hip. Rocking in and out. You can hold this for as long as you feel like you need. I'm gonna do 10 rocks. After 10 rocks, we're gonna pop up and switch the sides. Drop the right, kick the left back, swivel, and let's press our hip up and to the right. So again, 10 rocks here, but go as long as you feel like you need. And then we're gonna transition into cat-cow. So with cat-cow here, starting with our hands underneath our shoulders, knees underneath the hips, we're gonna press up and then down. Notice how I keep my elbows straight, shoulders are relaxed, we're not shrugging as we hold our cat. And then notice how I bring my chin and my tail underneath and press my chest to the ground. Let's get a nice flow here as we're moving back and forth.
ground, like a king without his crown. You're keep falling down. And I really want to leave, but can I get rid of your crown? You're trying to reach on through the heights and run down, bound on the ground. Giving up your pride, then you're
great. So staying in this position, we're just going to open our knees up a little wider and sit our hips as close to the heels as we can get them. So now, notice again how we have the toes engaged, so just getting a little bit of stretch in those big toes. We're gonna position our hands a little bit closer towards the knees so that we can position our shoulders nicely so we can relax them. As we push away from the ground, we're gonna look over our right and left shoulder. Let's do that 10 times. So as I'm moving back and forth, I wanna pretend like my eyes are on a line, and we're making sure our head stays in a neutral position as we look over our left and right shoulder. Continuing with some spine movements, we're going to take our foam roller, and this time we're going to go into a similar position like we had in the wall, okay? But now, as we press our hip down, we should feel a nice stretch on our downside hip. And now here, we're gonna continue our theme with the spine movements. So we're gonna drop our elbow, reach up towards the ceiling, up and down, four, five with the knee down. And now let's get that back knee up. So I extend that back knee, pull my rib cage up. Let's do another five. Trying to turn my chest with my eyes and hand. Switching up, let's bring the right foot by the right hand, drop that left knee, and I'm really pressing my left hip down towards the ground so I feel a nice stretch through here. For rotations. Bring that back knee up. So next, we're gonna try the yoga table. So at yoga table, we're gonna keep our feet just far enough from our hips that we have just less than a 90 degree angle here. My fingers are gonna be running behind me. I've also seen people hold in this position, but I find it to be pretty stressful on the wrist. So we're gonna press up, try to drive through our hips, press our chest towards the ceiling. We're gonna take five deep breaths. Long exhale. Breath in, long exhale. So now as we complete these last few exhales, what I want to pay attention to is where I'm feeling pressure. I should feel pressure in my hips, not my lower back. So if we are feeling our lower back, just drop our hips a little bit. And I should also feel some tension going on in my shoulders. Try to open those shoulders up as we take one last deep breath in. Long exhale. Moving on, we're gonna go into a side plank. So at side plank, we're actually gonna shorten it up a little bit. We're gonna keep our knees bent, and my pressure is gonna be through my bottom knee and my elbow. Keeping a nice straight line here, I'm trying to pull my ribs down towards my hips, feeling some tension in between that area. And we're gonna go up and down with the knee, the ankle traveling at the same height, at the same speed for 10 times. We should be feeling some tension going on in this bottom hip right here. So if you want to go with, we call these abductions, you can do that. If you feel better going with clamshells, that might be an easier option that helps you hit the lateral rotators. Let's switch the sides. So again, position ourselves so we bend the knees, press through our bottom elbow and bottom knee, rib cage to hips, up and down. So we're gonna go for 10 here. Or 10 clamshells. Finishing it up, we're gonna go into a downward dog series. So instead of going from push-up position, we're gonna start into bear. So starting into bear, we're gonna go knees under the hips, hands underneath. We're gonna tuck our tail just a little bit as we lift up. We know we did a good job if we feel our lower belly's on, and we're gonna press up. Take a deep breath in. Long exhale down. So don't drop the knees all the way to the floor as you exhale. Nice deep breath in. Long exhale. Deep breath in. Long exhale. And we're going to go one more time. Deep breath in. Long exhale. Now, 20 minutes is a nice short routine. However, we could have held any of these positions for longer or actually done the whole routine again one more time, including longer breaths, longer stretches, or just more repetitions as needed. I hope you enjoyed our routine for today. If you have any questions, feel free to leave some in the comment section below. Be sure to like and subscribe. Have a good day.